of Salima here in Malawi. I'm your host, Wezi Nyanewa Sosola. Right now we are on top of Namalenje Island. It's a hill standing on the beautiful, the awesome Lake Malawi. And guys, it's so amazing. The views, as you can see behind me, is the Lake Malawi. The creator did an amazing job. He took his time, and I'm in awe of this creator. But today, what I want to discuss with you, I've just brought a natural resource management specialist whom I just picked up and said, hey, help me out sharing with the people some facts that makes this our beautiful lake unique, the unique facts that comes with the Lake of Malawi. So just stay tuned and be blessed. Thank you. Welcome so much, Mr. Natural Resource Management Specialist, and address the people. Thank you.
Hello. Just give me 2 minutes. I'm live in studio. Yeah, just 2 minutes. I'm going to call you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Yeah, thanks very much, Wes Sosola, for being your guest today. As she has rightly said, we are right at the Namalenje Island in Lake Malawi. I just want to share with you some thoughts about Lake Malawi. Lake Malawi is not just a mere lake in Africa. It's one of the great African lakes in Africa that were formed by the lifting and the faulting of the tectonic plates close to the Indian Ocean. Among the lakes is Lake Victoria, Lake Tanganyika, Lake Turkana, and others. And this is the farthest south freshwater lake in this part of the world. And again, I just want to say two, if not three, amazing facts about Lake Malawi. Lake Malawi is referred to as a calendar lake. But what does it mean? Many people have asked me that question. It just means that just like in a year, in a calendar year, there are 365 days. And Lake Malawi, amazingly, is 365 miles long, meaning from Chitipa to Mangoji. It's about 365 nautical miles. And again, it is 52 miles wide, at the widest part of Lake Malawi. And you know there are 52 weeks in a year. And another amazing fact about Lake Malawi that makes it a calendar lake is because it has got a total of 12 rivers that flow into Lake Malawi, and some of them are from Tanzania and Mozambique, but the largest part of that comes from the Malawian watershed. And this is amazing facts about Lake Malawi. And again, Lake Malawi has got it's the most diverse freshwater lake in the world. We see people that come from the Europe and the America just to appreciate the most diverse fish species that are found in our lake. And these species are endemic. What does it mean when we say these fishes are endemic? It means you cannot find them elsewhere in the world. You only need to come to Cape Maclear, or you need to come to Likoma Island, or any other island where these species are localized. And building up on this fact, being the most biodiverse lake, and the UN organization that is responsible for education, cultural, it's called UNESCO, sat down with the Malawi government and designated the southern tip of Lake Malawi, Cape Maclear, as the protected area. And they called that one a cultural heritage site. And we gazetted some part of the Cape Maclear part of the Lake Malawi National Park. And Lake Malawi is the only freshwater lake that has got a protected area, a national park. So amazing. Aren't you so excited that our lake is so amazing?
Yay!
Okay, let me finish with the species now. There are more than a thousand secret fishes. What other people call them, the mbunas, the colored fish. And let me amaze you, people, also chambo is a secret. We eat chambo. Lake Malawi is known for its chambo. And chambo is one of the secret species. But there are many other secret species that we don't eat. These are the colored ones, the ones that are used for aquarium. And these are some of the amazing facts that I wanted to talk about. Let me finish up, because I said I've got 4 facts. Another issue is we have collected data about Lake Malawi since 1822 up to date. The data is showing some fluctuation of the water levels. And there was a time that the Lake Malawi went so low, realize that there are times that, particularly in 1982, it went so high, and the level of fluctuation has changed by 6 meters. What it means now, it has gone up by 6 meters, and there was a time that went down by 6 meters below. So what it means is, over a period of time, Lake Malawi will be fluctuating. Now, because there are rivers that flow into Lake Malawi, and there is only one outlet, and this is Chile River. People, we have made some permutation. If rain will not come in one particular year, assuming that the rivers will not bring any inflow into Lake Malawi, with the vastness of Lake Malawi, consider Lake Malawi as a basin. How long do you think it will take for Malawi to be drained off by Chile? How long would it take? Many people think it will take about maybe 20 years, or it will take about 100 years. But the amazing fact about the vastness of Lake Malawi is it will take more than 200 years to drain it off. Thanks very much, Wesley, for being your guest. I just wanted to talk about Lake Malawi. Thank you.
Thank you so much, my guest. Today, guys, as you have seen for yourself, so amazing facts about this lake, Lake Malawi. And I would like to invite you, if you are trying to make a destination decision of where to go for holidays, come and visit us. Come and share this amazing experience with us. We've got so many attractive places here in Malawi, and right adjacent to this place, we've got the Livingstonia Beach Hotel. We also have got the Waterfront Hotel, and there are so many other accommodation places wherever you would choose based on your pocket. So thank you so much, guys. I appreciate you for being with me, and stay blessed. Thank you.